Hi friends, today we are going to discuss very basic concepts of data science, artificial intelligence, machine learning and deep learning. Please watch this video till end. So this is a very interesting topic. So first you understand this terminologies in the data science, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning. So in further my lectures you can easily understand what I am telling. Okay. So first we have to discuss what is the data science. So data science is a domain that includes working with the huge amount of the data and developing the models like machine learning and deep learning. So here with the help of the amount of the data, we can suppose to develop the models like machine learning and deep learning. So these, we can use these models used as a tools. Okay, so data science is nothing but solving the problems with the help of the data. So get the knowledge from the data. So here main key role is the data. So without data we can't do anything. So data is the main key role. So for solving the problems we need the data. So initially our goal was to identify the hidden patterns in the raw data to help the business to enhance and expand their profits. So which means that to identify the hidden patterns means we can take the initially raw data. So this raw data, there is no meaningful without understanding the relationship between this data, we can't able to make the model. So we have to understand the relationship between the features in the data, we have to extract the knowledge from the data with the help of the data science. So data science is the general term. So under the data science, there is a subfields, artificial intelligence, machine learning and deep learning. Okay, so here data scientist, he performs the research and analysis on the data and helps the companies to improve their business and predicting their growth and trends and business insights based on the huge amount of data. So nowadays, so some companies like Amazon, Flipkart and big companies, so what they are doing, so they are using the data. So with the help of the models, we have to develop the models based on the data, we have to predict their growth and trends. Okay, for example, if you see Amazon, if you search for one mobiles in Amazon, so based on frequently which kind of devices, which kind of items you are supposed to searching in the website, so here the model is capturing the what you are understanding, what you need. So based on your interest, so the model is suggests you like the devices what you are looking for, like that. So data science can be performed on the data by using some tools. Which kind of tools? So here we are using mainly three tools, like as R programming. R is a one tool. This is a popular and it's a free, it's a open source. Like R, another tool is a Python. It is also like popular and it is a competition with this R programming. So third one is the Tableau. It is a popular for the visual analytics in small and mid-sized data sets, and it is very easy to use. So these are the three popular tools in data science we are supposed to apply. So if you see, it's a data science. So here deep learning is a subset of the machine learning. So deep learning is a subset of the machine learning, and machine learning is a subset of the artificial intelligence and data science. So this is a combination of the deep learning, machine learning and artificial intelligence. So here we have to discuss one by one in detail. So what is the artificial intelligence? So artificial intelligence, it is a technique that enables the computers or machine to mimic the human behavior. So means AI helps us to enable the machines to think without human interventions. So machines are able to take the own decisions. Means here artificial intelligence, it enables the machines to think without any human interventions. So the machines will able to take their own decisions. Machines will take able to their own decisions. So here finally we have to create the AI applications. Finally we have to create the AI applications. Okay. So AI is not about the coding. It's about to understand the model. Understand the model. So model means by using the some algorithms, we have to develop this some machine learning models and some deep learning models. So how you understand the model and how you are going to use that model as a tool to get a better solution. For getting the better solution, how you can able to apply the model. So that is the AI. So it specifically focused on making the devices more intelligent. So means that it think as well as the humans. So we are making the devices like intelligent. So these devices will think like humans. So such devices are be trained to solve these problems and learn in better way than humans do. So means we have to train the devices like robots, for example robots. So we have to make the robots more intelligent, and these robots will think like humans, and these robots will be resolve the some problems and better than the humans. So finally we have to create the AI applications. So for example, self-driving car and robots, these are the best examples of the artificial intelligence. Next, machine learning. So machine learning, it is an application of the artificial intelligence that provides the computer's ability to learn and improve from experience, from improve their past experience without being explicitly programmed. Here means the primary aim is to allow the computers to learn automatically without human interventions. So here machine learning is always try to find the pattern based on some mathematical equations. So here machine learning define the relationship between the with the help of the some equations. For example, linear regression, the equation is equal to y is equal to mx plus b. Here x is our input variable and y is our target variable. So based on our input variables, we have to predict the our target variable. So means this is one kind of equations. So means that we have to find the pattern with the help of the some mathematical equations. So machine learning, it provides the some statistical tools. Provide some statistical tools to explore and analyze the data. So what is the mean by explore? To understand the data. So without understanding data, we can't able to go further. So first we have to understand the data. First we have to understand the problem statement. So machine learning, so it is a statistical tool. It provides the some statistical tools to explore the data and to analyze the data. So example is systems are classify the emails spam or not spam. So machine learning are basically three types. So supervised learning and unsupervised learning and reinforcement learning. So in supervised learning means it is known class labels. So known the class labels means that we have the past data. So the data may be here we know our target variable means we know the output. So what we are going to make the prediction, make the prediction we know before itself. That is the supervised learning. So in supervised learning, basically two types are existed. One is the regression kind of problems, and second one is the classification kind of problems. So in regression kind of problems, suppose if you example is to predict the predict the salary of employees, predict the salaries of employees, and to predict the profit of the company, so like that. So based on the target variable, we can going to apply the regression kind of problems. So here classification of algorithms means, in this, for example, regression kind of problems, examples are the linear regression, means simple linear regression, multiple linear regression, polynomial linear regression, like that. If it is a classification problem statements, based on the target variable. So based on the target variable means based on the variable, means it is a binary variable or a multivariable. So based on the target variable, we have to apply the classification algorithms, like logistic regression. So logistic regression, decision tree, random forest classifier, support vector machine, and KNN algorithm. So like this, some of the algorithms are existed on the classification algorithm. So next one is the unsupervised learning. So here there is no class labels, means here there is no target variable, no target variable. So in this unsupervised learning, we don't know what we are going to make the prediction. So here, not having the labeled data, so I don't know what is the output in this unsupervised learning kind of problems. So here we using the, by using unsupervised learning, we can solve the some clustering kind of problems. Some clustering, clustering, clustering kind of problems. So for clustering kind of problems, we have some techniques like k-means clustering, hierarchical means clustering, db-scan clustering. So these are the popular techniques we can suppose to apply in the clustering algorithms. So what is the mean by clustering? So based on the similarity of the data, it will try to group together. So in the clustering, we have to apply this some mathematical concepts like Euclidean distance concepts, Manhattan distance concept, we have to apply in unsupervised learning. So in upcoming videos, we have to in detail, I will explain this concepts, clustering and popular clustering algorithms. So third one is the reinforcement learning. So some data are labeled and some are not labeled. So means some part of the data is labeled and some part of the data will not be labeled. So what are the applications of machine learning? So machine learnings are used in various scientific areas. Scientific areas means bioinformatics, biochemistry, medicines, metallurgy, economic sciences, robotics, food security, and climatology. So mainly, machine learning applications, these models are used in agricultural industry. So agriculture industry means like these models, what we are going to make the models with the help of the machine learning, these models can help the farmers to predict the crop yield and crop quality, weed detection, disease detection, and disease classification. Those kind of problems we have to solve with the help of the machine learning techniques. So deep learning. So deep learning is a subset of the machine learning. So here deep learning creates an architecture called the multi neural network architecture. So deep learning creates the multi neural network architecture. So the main idea behind the deep learning is to mimic the human brain. So it is a subset of the machine learning. So deep learning is a subset of the machine learning. So deep learning generally considered a sub-branch of the machine learning. It involves the algorithms that can be learned underlying the features in the data using some neural networks. So we can make the machine learn like how we can learn with the help of the human brain. So use the multi-neural network architecture in this deep learning. So example is classify the handwritten digit for recognition. So why deep learning? Why deep learning means there are the four important points. So first point is, point number one is the process the huge amount of the data. So machine learning algorithms works with the only small and medium amount of the structured data, but deep learning can works with the huge amount of the structured and unstructured data. So even data may be structured, unstructured, the data may be huge, then at that moment of time we are going to use the deep learning techniques. So second one is the performance perform the complex algorithm. So machine learning algorithms cannot perform the complex operations, but deep learning can perform the complex operations. So point number three, to achieve the best performance with the large amount of data. So as the amount of data is increasing, the performance of the machine learning is decreasing, but deep learning algorithm performance is better, means increasing when the huge amount of the data. And fourth point, feature extraction. So machine learning algorithms extract the features manually. So extract the features manually based on the labeled data. So labeled data means input variables and output variables. So both existed in, we used to call the labeled data. So means the machine learning algorithm extract the features manually based on the labeled data. So deep learning take the huge volume of the data as the input and analyze the input data to extract the features. So means that, so this is the main difference between the machine learning and deep learning. So in machine learning, features are extracted by manually, but in deep learning, features will be extracted by the system itself based on the huge volume of the input data. So there are three main deep learning techniques are there. So what are the three main deep learning techniques? Artificial neural network, convolutional neural network, recurrent neural network. So artificial neural network means ANN, CNN, RN. So when we use the three deep learning techniques, when the input data is in the form of numerical data, numerical form, at that moment we are going to apply the artificial neural network. So when the input data is in the form of images and videos, at that moment of time we can use the convolutional neural network. So this convolutional neural network are used for the image recognition, image classification, object detection, and recognize the faces. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So CNN algorithms mainly applicable for the image recognition, image classification, object detection, recognition of the faces. So in CNN, some popular CNN architectures are existed. So what are the popular CNN architecture means? AlexNet. AlexNet. Second one is the VGGNet. Third one is GoogleNet. Fourth one, ResNet. So these are some popular CNN architectures that existed. And third one is the recurrent neural network, when the input data is in the form of time series data. So time series kind of data, we have to apply the recurrent neural network. So what is the difference machine learning versus deep learning? So based on the data dependency, means performs the small and medium data sets, machine learning is be performed very well. So deep learning is performed on the huge amount of the data set. Second one is the hardware dependencies. So machine learning performs on low configurations like CPUs, minimum configuration is supported for machine learning. For deep learning, we need high configurations like GPU. So feature engineering. So in machine learning, so we have to carefully understand the features in the data and how it represents the data. So here we have to manually features we have to use for train the model. So but here we have to understand the functionality. So many functionalities are exist in the deep learning. So among the functionalities, we have to identify the best optimal functionality to represent the data. And execution time, so from few minutes to hours, means depends upon the data and depends on the configuration, depends on the algorithms, it will take the time, execution time. So here also depends upon the GPU or configuration, means CPU or GPU. So deep learning mainly focuses on the GPU and the data set, and depends upon the model. So it's based on the models, based on the data set, it will take the time. So when to use the machine learning and deep learning? So when the training data set is very small, at that moment machine learning is used. But deep learning, when the training data set is very huge, at that moment we can suppose to apply the deep learning. So choose the features. So before train the model, we have to manually choose the features, means best features by using the feature selection techniques in machine learning. But in deep learning, no, we can't choose the features. So system itself take the features by applying the some techniques like permutation combinations between the different layers. So number of algorithms are many, here very few. So training time is less compared to deep learning. So deep learning training time is more. So what are the applications of deep learning? Cancer detection. So deep learning can helps to detect the cancer tumor in the human brain. And robot navigation. So here also, these deep learning models can suppose to apply to train the robots to perform the human tasks. So to perform the human tasks better than the human tasks, we have to apply the robots. So self-driving cars and machine translations. So we have to give the word or phrase or sentence in one language. Automatically, that deep learning can translate into another language. For machine translation, we suppose to apply the deep learning. So here, brief summary of the how everything works. So deep learning is a subset of the machine learning, and machine learning is a subset of the artificial intelligence. Okay. So here, deep learning means subcategory of the machine learning is suitable for the self-driving algorithms and feature extraction. But here, the systems or algorithms that are designed to learn the structure to predict the future outcome. So artificial intelligence means it is a concept of intelligence demonstrated by the machines. So here data science means, so this is the nothing but the data science. So data science is about to understand the pattern. It's about to understand the pattern in the data. And machine learning, deep learning. So machine learning and deep learning. So machine learning and deep learning will understand the patterns in the data. So data science is a technique which try to apply these models, deep learning and machine learning. So use this some of the mathematical tools, statistics and probability and linear algebra. So some mathematical tools we have to apply in the data science. So here, as a data scientist, he has to work with the deep learning, he has to work with the machine learning, finally he has to create this model and apply these models as a applications in the artificial intelligence. So as a data scientist, he has this some more knowledge in the statistics, probability, linear algebra, and working with these models. So main concept of machine learning and deep learning is to derive the finally AI applications. So when you use to artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning with the big data, in addition to mathematical stuff like statistics, probability, linear algebra, and different calculus we have to use, then it is the implementing the data science. So this is the basic terminologies in data science, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. If you like this video, please share it and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.